Hello, I'm Maruk Saeed, your microbiology guide. Let's explore in-depth micro techniques and uncover groundbreaking insight together on this educational journey into the fascinating realms of microbes.
Nocardia is a genus of gram-positive, branching filamentous rods that are frequently found in soil. There are around 80 species of Nocardia, with approximately 30 of them causing sickness in people. The most noteworthy include Nocardia asteroids, Nocardia brasiliensis, Nocardia syriaci georgica, Nocardia farcinica, and Nocardia nova. Nocardia produces nocardiosis, a disease that has three primary forms: pulmonary, cutaneous, and disseminated. Okay, we've demonstrated that Nocardia is a rod-shaped gram-positive bacteria, which becomes purple when stained with gram. When there are lots of them, they form purple branching filaments. They are obligate aerobes, which means they require oxygen to develop. They are also non-motile and do not produce spores. But wait, that sounds exactly like Actinomyces israeli, another kind of rod-shaped, gram-positive, filamentous bacterium with many other similarities. To differentiate them, an acid-fast stain, also known as the Ziehl-Nielsen stain, is used. In this test, a red dye called carbon fuchsin attaches to lipids in the cell wall and turns them red. Then alcohol is used to remove any dye that has not colored the bacteria, and a second dye, methylene blue, is added. Nocardia is a weak acid-fast bacterium, which indicates that a less concentrated alcohol solution is required for staining since the mycolic acids in its cell wall are of intermediate length. Because it contains a lot of lipids in its cell wall, it maintains the carbon fuchsin and appears red under a microscope, making it an acid-fast bacteria. On the other hand, in bacteria with few lipids in their cell walls, such as Actinomyces israeli, all of the red dye is washed away by alcohol, resulting in a blue appearance under the microscope, indicating that it is a non-acid-fast bacteria. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Oramine rhodamine dye may also be used in fluorescence microscopy to visualize Nocardia, which produces a reddish-yellow glow. This stain is less specific than the Ziehl-Nielsen stain, thus it produces more false positive findings. Nevertheless, it is more sensitive, producing fewer false negative results, and it is also less costly. As a result, the Oramine rhodamine stain is frequently utilized during screening. Another distinction is that Nocardia is catalase positive, which means it produces an enzyme called catalase that converts hydrogen peroxide to water and oxygen, as well as urease positive, which means it produces an enzyme called urease that breaks down urea into ammonia and carbon dioxide, whereas Actinomyces israeli is both catalase and urease negative. Finally, Nocardia species may grow on ordinary medium like blood agar or chocolate agar, selective media like modified Thayer-Martin agar or BCYE agar, mycobacterial media like Lowenstein-Jensen agar, and fungus media like Saburo-dextrose agar. Nocardia produces white, yellow, or orange long branching filamentous colonies with a powdered appearance that typically take 3 to 5 days to grow, but can sometimes take up to 3 weeks. Nocardia now has a low pathogenicity. Therefore, nocardiosis is more common as an opportunistic infection in immunocompromised persons. It enters the body by inhalation or cutaneous damage and is then absorbed by macrophages. Inside macrophages, it is enveloped in a vesicle known as a phagosome, which generally combines with lysosomes to create a phagolysosome, where bacteria are destroyed by lysosomal enzymes. However, Nocardia's cell wall includes a cord factor, or trehalose dimicholate, a glycolipid that prevents phagolysosomal fusion. Another immune system weapon is that neutrophils and macrophages attack invading bacteria by producing a large number of harmful oxygen radicals, such as superoxide, as a result of an oxidative metabolic burst. However, Nocardia produces two enzymes that deactivate these dangerous oxygen radicals. First, there's superoxide dismutase, which converts superoxide radicals to oxygen and hydrogen peroxide. Because hydrogen peroxide is still toxic, Nocardia also produces catalase, which converts hydrogen peroxide into water. In pulmonary nocardiosis, the presence of Nocardia causes an inflammatory response that attracts additional macrophages to the site of combat. As more of them arrive, they surround the bacterium on all sides, forming a granuloma that keeps it from spreading. Caseous necrosis, which literally means cheese-like necrosis, occurs in the middle of the granuloma, where the tissue dies and becomes soft, white, and resembles cheese. Now, the most prevalent kind of nocardiosis is pulmonary nocardiosis, which is often caused by the inhalation of Nocardia asteroids. Pulmonary nocardiosis can occur in immunocompromised people, such as those with HIV infection, cancer, or chronic granulomatous disease, all of which are associated with low granulocyte counts, or in people with underlying lung disease, such as chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, cystic fibrosis, or bronchiectasis. Pulmonary nocardiosis can proceed to pneumonia with cavitary lesions, pleural effusion, or fluid in the pleural cavity, and empyema, which occurs when pus accumulates in the pleural cavity. Disseminated nocardiosis is typically a complication of pulmonary nocardiosis, and the bacterium frequently spreads to the central nervous system, producing meningitis or brain abscesses, or to the heart, causing endocarditis. Cutaneous nocardiosis, on the other hand, is caused by Nocardia brasiliensis and often affects immunocompetent individuals when the infection enters the body via skin sores. Cutaneous nocardiosis manifests in three clinical presentations. Firstly, as a superficial skin infection that may escalate to cellulitis or the inflammation of subcutaneous tissue, accompanied by the formation of skin abscesses. Secondly, it presents as deep skin infections, notably mycetomas, characterized by their chronic nature and progressive destruction, affecting the skin, subcutaneous tissues, muscles, and potentially extending to the bone. And lastly, there's lymphocutaneous infection, wherein the bacteria disseminates to lymphatic vessels, potentially leading to the formation of lymphatic abscesses. When regional lymph nodes are afflicted, lymphocutaneous nocardiosis is referred to as sporotrichoid nocardiosis due to its similarities to Sporothrix schenskii, a fungal illness. Now, symptoms are determined by the type of sickness. So, pulmonary nocardiosis causes fever, cough with sputum production, shortness of breath, and hemoptysis, or blood in the sputum if the lungs have cavities. Disseminated illness can cause symptoms of meningitis and brain abscesses, such as fever, headache, stiff neck, and altered mental state, as well as endocarditis, which causes fever and new heart murmurs. Finally, skin infections. Cellulitis causes erythema, or redness, soreness, and purulent discharge, whereas abscesses can cause local redness, heat, swelling, and discomfort. Lymphocutaneous infections cause lesions to spread along the course of dermal and subcutaneous lymphatics, whereas mycetomas cause swelling, distortion of the afflicted region, and many drainage orifices that exude pus. Nocardia is diagnosed in smears or cultures of respiratory secretions, skin biopsy samples, aspirates from abscesses or CSF, and blood in cases of disseminated illness. When pulmonary nocardiosis is suspected, a PPD test should be performed to exclude out tuberculosis, as the symptoms are almost identical. A chest X-ray can be used to detect abnormal nodules, cavities, pulmonary infiltrates, lung abscess development, or pleural effusions. A brain MRI can also be used to detect brain abscesses, while an echocardiography can reveal bacterial vegetations on the heart, confirming endocarditis. Treatment sulfonamides are used to treat nocardia infections, with trimethoprim sulfamethoxazole being the most commonly prescribed medication. Imipenem, amikacine, and linezolid are common alternatives used in severe situations. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Okay, just a brief summary. Nocardia is a gram-positive, branching, filamentous rod bacterium commonly found in soil. It is a non-modal, non-spore-producing, obligate aerobe, catalase, and urease-positive, weak acid-fast bacillus that may be detected with Ziehl-Neelsen and auramine-rhodamine stain. It can grow on a variety of medias into white, yellow, or orange filamentous colonies with a powdery appearance. It possesses a few virulence factors, including cord factor, catalysis, and superoxide dismutase, which it exploits to escape the immune system. It produces nocardiosis, which comes in three forms: cutaneous, pulmonary, and disseminated. Bacteria are identified in a smear or culture from respiratory secretions, skin biopsy samples, aspirates from abscesses or CSF, and blood in cases of disseminated illness, and trimethoprim sulfamethoxazole is used as the first line of therapy.